Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. I work with business owners and entrepreneurs to help them to get their books set up properly using QuickBooks Online so they have up-to-the-minute information on a regular basis to make decisions to better manage their business and their cash flow. Today we're going to look at credit card credits. These are the credits that you enter when you receive a refund, perhaps you've returned something, or maybe a service wasn't delivered and you've got a credit on your credit card statement. This is not those more challenging credits in QuickBooks Online that can be really quite difficult, and I still have to try to make a video to explain those. But these are the simple credits that come through on your credit card statement when you've returned something or just for whatever reason received a credit. So we'll walk through those steps now. So the first thing that you want to do is have a look at where you recorded the initial expense. So for that reason, I thought that we'd pop over here into banking and we would record this amount here as though this was what we're going to subsequently return. So we know it's Supplies Depot and we're going to say office supplies, just office expenses. Here we go. And I'm going to put no tax on it and add it. So we have $24.68 from Supplies Depot for office expenses, and we're adding in the expense. So this is when we very first bought it. So now what we're going to do is we've returned it to Office Depot. We're going to go up and record a credit card credit. So we pop up here to New and look at this credit card credit. So who are we returning these items to or receiving the credit from? So in this example, it's Supplies Depot. And it's from our credit card. We'd have a look here. That's actually our only option for a credit card. We would put in the date. So the purchase was the 25th of August. So let's say we went back in there on Monday on the 30th and returned it. And you might remember that we allocated the expense to office expenses. So this is where we want to take it out of. So we'll pop in here now to office expenses. And we'll put $24.68. Now it's important to use exactly the same sales tax rate for both entries, because obviously if you've claimed taxes for one of them, you're going to want to make sure that you don't claim it if you've returned it. So I didn't use tax. I'm going to pop exempt back in here and then we save and close. Now, as you can see, Visa credit card is connected. So when we, in our real, not the sample company file, update our transactions, that credit is going to come in and it's going to come in on this received column. And then it should just automatically match. The other option, of course, is that you wait until it does come in on this received column, and then you can categorize it directly from the bank feed. But I always think it's important to know how to go about recording these things prior to the bank feed. It's just good practice, don't you think?
It's really important to reconcile your credit card on a regular basis. If you've added credits incorrectly or haven't recorded them or have anything messed up, doing that reconciliation is how you'll make sure that your records are accurate. So if you haven't recorded the credit, your expenses will be too high. Or if you've somehow done it twice, it'll look like it's too low and you won't be using accurate information. I have another video on how to do a credit card reconciliation, and I've just recently updated that as well. So check out, I've got to work out which side that link is on. Check it out, and that will hopefully help you to keep everything accurate on a regular basis. If this video was useful, click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.